Hey friends, welcome to the YouTube channel All About Electronics. So in this video, we will learn about the ripple carry adder. So in the previous video, we learned about the half adder and the full adder circuit. And we have also seen the circuit diagram of this half adder and the full adder. And then we have also seen that how to design the full adder using two half adder and one OR gate. So this full adder circuit can add the two 1-bit numbers along with the carry bit, and it gives the sum and the carry bit as the output. But if you want to add two 4-bit numbers, for example, let's say these two numbers, then we require four such full adders for each row. So now let us see the schematic of this 4-bit adder. So as you can see, there are four full adders, and this A and B are the two 4-bit numbers. So this full adder 0 or the FA0 adds the LSB A0 and the B0, and it generates the sum bit S0 and the carry bit C1. So while adding the LSB, since there will not be any previous carry, so here this C0 bit is set to 0. Now the generated carry from the full adder FA0 is given as an input to the next full adder. So now this full adder FA1 adds the two bits A1 and B1 along with the previous carry C1, which is generated from the previous adder. And likewise, the subsequent full adder adds the two bits along with the carry, which is generated from the previous adder. And in the output, they generate the sum bit and the carry bit. So this is the schematic of the 4-bit adder. Now let's say these are the two 4-bit numbers. And if we add them using this 4-bit adder, then this A0 and the B0 is equal to 0 and 1. And like I said, for the addition of these least significant bits, this carry bit C0 is set to 0. So for the first full adder, the sum bit is equal to 1, while the carry bit is equal to 0. So now, this carry bit is the input to the next adder. And for the next adder, this A1 is equal to 1, while the B1 is equal to 0. So the output sum bit is equal to 1, while the carry bit is equal to 0. Similarly, for this third adder FA2, this A2 is equal to 0, while the B2 is equal to 1. And the incoming carry from the previous adder is equal to 0. That means for this full adder FA2, the output sum bit is equal to 1, while the carry bit is equal to 0. So now, for the last adder, this carry bit is equal to 0, while both A3 and B3 is equal to 1. So for this last full adder, the output sum bit is equal to 0, while the carry bit is equal to 1. So in this way, using this 4-bit adder, we will get this 0111 as the sum bits, and the outgoing carry bit is equal to 1. So in this way, by connecting the 4 full adders, we can add the two 4-bit numbers. And similarly, by connecting two 4-bit adders, we can also build the 8-bit adder. So here, the output carry of this one 4-bit adder is given as an input to the next 4-bit adder. So here, the adder FA0 to FA3 adds the lower 4 bits, while the adders FA4 to FA7 adds the higher 4 bits. And in this way, in general, by connecting n full adders parallelly, we can build the n-bit adder. So this adder is also known as the parallel adder, because here the addition of all the bits in the number is happening parallelly, and the carry from the one adder is given as an input to the next adder. Now so far in our discussion, we have assumed that the moment we apply the input bits, then the sum bit and the carry bit of each adder is available at the output instantaneously. But in reality, once we apply the input bits, then the valid output is available after certain delay, and this delay is known as the propagation delay. So typically, this delay ranges from nanosecond to microsecond. So for the given digital block, this delay depends on the internal circuit of that block as well as the propagation delay of the individual logic gate in the given circuit. So for a time being, let's say we do not know the internal circuit of the full adder, and we also do not know the propagation delay of the each logic gate in the given full adder. But what we know is that for the given full adder, the propagation delay to generate the sum output is equal to Ts, while the propagation delay to generate the carry output is equal to Tc. Let's say both these times are 15 nanosecond. That means once we apply the input to this full adder, then after 15 nanosecond, the valid sum bit and the carry bit will be available. And using 4 such full adders, this 4-bit adder is designed. So considering this, now let us understand the issue or the limitation of this 4-bit adder. So here, although the input bits to the all full adders are applied simultaneously, but the availability of the each valid carry input depends on the previous stage. For example, this full adder FA3 cannot perform the valid addition until this valid carry bit C3 is available, and the availability of this carry bit C3 depends on the FA2. But this full adder FA2 can perform this valid addition only after this C2 input is available. So in short, because of the propagation delay of the each full adder, the particular full adder has to wait until all the previous full adders perform the addition and generates the corresponding carry output. And among all the full adders, the last full adder at the MSB position has to wait for the longest time. For example, this full adder FA0 will generate the sum and the carry bit after its own propagation delay. So in this case, that is equal to 15 nanosecond. So this full adder 1 has to wait until the 15 nanosecond. So once this C1 bit is available, then this full adder FA1 will generate the sum and the carry bit after its own propagation delay. That means this C2 and the S1 will be available after 15 plus 15 nanosecond. That is equal to 30 nanosecond. So this valid carry bit C2 is available only after 30 nanosecond. That means this full adder FA2 has to wait until 30 nanosecond, and it will generate the valid carry and the sum output at the 45 nanosecond. So as you can see, the last full adder has to wait till 45 nanosecond to get the valid carry input, and after that only it can perform the valid addition. That means this C4 and the S3 will be available only after 60 nanoseconds. That means for this 4-bit adder, we will get the valid sum result only after 60 nanosecond. So in general, we can say that the full adder at the MSB position has to wait until 3TC time, where TC is the propagation delay for generating the carry output for each full adder. So after this 3TC time, the full adder will generate the carry output at 4TC time and the sum output at 3TC plus TS time, where the TS is the time required to generate the sum output for each full adder. So in general, we can say that for the end bit adder, if TC is not equal to TS, then the time which is required to generate the valid sum output is equal to n minus 1 times TC plus TS. Similarly, the total propagation delay for generating the carry output is equal to n times TC. That means after this time only, we will get the valid addition of this n-bit adder. So as you can see, in this parallel adder, the valid sum output is available only after the carry propagates through each stage. So this adder is also known as the ripple carry adder, because here the carry propagates through each full adder stage or ripples through the each stage before it appears at the final stage. And the time which is required for this carry bit to reach from the first stage to the final stage is known as the carry propagation delay. And as the number of stages increases, then this carry propagation delay will also increase. So this delay reduces the number of additions that can be performed in 1 second. So that is the limitation of this ripple carry adder. So the question is, how we can reduce this propagation delay? So the simple answer is, we need to reduce this delay times TC and TS. And to achieve that, we need to optimize our design and we need to select the logic gates with the minimum propagation delays. But the thing is, we cannot reduce the propagation delay of the logic gates below certain limit. So this issue can be eliminated to a certain extent by using the another type of adder. And this adder is known as the look-ahead carry adder. So in the next video, we will learn about this look-ahead carry adder in detail. But before we end this video, let us take one example related to ripple carry adder. So in this example, we have been asked to find the worst case carry propagation delay of the 4-bit adder. So here, we have been given the design of each full adder, and we have been also given the propagation delay of the each logic gate in the given design. So here, each full adder is designed using 2 half adders and 1 OR gate. Or this is the logic circuit of the full adder. So here, the propagation delay of the each XOR gate is equal to T XOR, and the propagation delay of the each AND and the OR gate is equal to TP. So here, this T XOR is equal to 20 nanosecond, while the propagation delay of this AND and the OR gate is equal to 10 nanosecond. So for this given 4-bit adder, now let us find the worst case carry propagation delay. And for that, first of all, let us find the propagation delay of the individual full adder. So here, as you can see, this sum output is available after 2 XOR gate delays, while the carry output is available after T XOR plus 2 TP, because this is the maximum propagation delay which is required for generating this carry output. So in this case, this sum output is available after 40 nanosecond, while this carry output is also available after 40 nanosecond. So this is the case of the one full adder circuit. But here, 4 such full adders are cascaded. So let us find the worst case carry propagation delay of this 4-bit adder. So far from our discussion, one can think that if for the one full adder, if delay is equal to 40 nanosecond, then for the 4 full adders, the carry output will be available after 4 times 40 nanosecond or 160 nanosecond, and similarly, the sum output will also be available after 160 nanosecond, right? But in that case, during our discussion, we didn't know the propagation delay of the each logic gate, and we also do not know the internal circuit of the full adder. So in such case, when we do not know the internal circuit as well as the propagation delay of the individual logic gate, then using the earlier method, we can find the worst case delay. But in this case, since we know the internal circuit as well as the propagation delay of the each logic gate, so we can exactly find the delay after each logic gate. So we have seen that for the first adder, the sum output is available after 2 XOR gates, while the carry output is available after 2 XOR plus 2 P time. And in this case, that is equal to 40 nanosecond. So this carry output C1 is available after 40 nanosecond. Meanwhile, since all the input bits of A and B are applied simultaneously, so the output of this XOR gate is already available after 1 XOR delay. So in this case, that is equal to 20 nanosecond. But since the valid C1 is available after 40 nanosecond, so this second XOR gate cannot generate the valid output before that time. And once the C1 is available, then the sum output will be generated after one more XOR delay. That means for the second full adder, the sum output will be available at T XOR plus 2 TP plus T XOR time. That means for the given full adder, as soon as the valid carry output is available from the previous stage, then the sum output will be generated after 1 XOR gate delay. So in this case, this time is equal to 60 nanosecond. Similarly, now let us see the carry output. So here, since all the bits of A and B are applied at the same time to the all adders, so the output of this first AND gate will be available after TP time. So in this case, that is equal to 10 nanosecond. That means one of the input to the OR gate is already available after 10 nanosecond. But the second valid input will be generated only after this C1 is available. So here, the output of this XOR gate is already available after 20 nanosecond. But this C1 is available after 40 nanosecond. That means this second AND gate can generate the valid output after the availability of the C1. So in this case, this time is equal to 40 nanosecond. And once this C1 is available, then it will generate the valid output after the TP time. And once that input is available, then this OR gate will take one more gate delay. That means the total time which is taken for generating this carry output is equal to T XOR plus 2 TP plus 2 TP, where this T XOR plus 2 TP is the time which is required to generate the C1 input. And this 2 TP is the gate delay of these two logic gates. That means as soon as the carry output C1 is available, then this C2 will be generated after two logic gates. And the same is true for the all adders. That means here, this valid input C1 is available after T XOR plus 2 TP time. And once this C1 is available, then this C2 will be available after 2 more gate delays. That is equal to T XOR plus 4 TP. And once this C2 is available to the full adder FA2, then it will generate the carry output after 2 more gate delays. That is equal to T XOR plus 6 TP. And similarly, this full adder FA3 will generate the carry output at T XOR plus 8 TP time. So as soon as this C3 is available, then as we have seen, the sum output will be available after 1 more XOR gate delay. That means this valid S3 output is available after 2 XOR plus 6 TP time. So in general, for the end bit adder, the valid final carry output is available after T XOR plus 2 NTP time. And likewise, the valid sum output is available after this time, where the N is the number of stages in the adder circuit. So in this case, since N is equal to 4, so this carry output is available after 100 nanosecond. And likewise, the sum output is also available after 100 nanosecond. That means for the given 4-bit adder, the worst case carry propagation delay is equal to 100 nanosecond. And the given equations are valid only for the given question, where the full adder is designed using the 2 half adders and 1 OR gate. And here, the propagation delay of the AND and the OR gate in the circuit is also assumed to be the same. So in this way, we can find the worst case carry propagation delay of this ripple carry adder. So as you can see, since the carry is propagating from one state to the other stage, so the valid sum and the carry output is available only after the total carry propagation delay. And like I said, this issue can be resolved using the another type of adder circuit, which is known as the look-ahead carry adder. So in the next video, we will learn about it in detail. But I hope in this video, you learned about the ripple carry adder. So if you have any question or suggestion, then do let me know here in the comment section below. If you like this video, hit the like button and subscribe the channel for more such videos.